أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي.
You are not born to have a choice.
Can I ask one small thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to.
Yeah,
you're feeling fine. That's a command. Forgive me because you're begging for money.
You're begging, yes. Sir.
What does Allah? What humma? What's a humma?
Is it
for emphasis?
No. It's what we call again for tanbih. For tanbih. And in Arabic, sometimes you add sounds and things to the end of something. Just to emphasize in the way that you're making the person pay attention. You're stressing that fact, yeah? So, back to this. So, نزل, نزل, أنزل. What we say on a verb, pay attention to it because this applies to the language, it's not specific to this verb. So when we say رحم, راحم, مرحوم, the same thing, كسب, كاسب, مكسوب, نزل, نازل, منزول. Amen. So nazala, nazala معناها
to come down.
Yeah, nazala معناها to come down. واحد يتصل بي أين أنت؟ أقول له نزلت من البيت. So I've come down from there. So I'm reading my way. نزلت من البيت. So nazala, you are doing the action. Nazala. لكن ما معنى نزل أو أنزل to send down. You remember, we said, if you double the second letter or you add an alif at the beginning, that makes you do the action to someone else.
So نزل means to send down.
To send down. نزل, you go down, you come down. But نزل أو أنزل معناها to send down.
أنزل means the same thing.
The same thing. That's why. ما معنى علم؟
To know.
To know. كيف نقول to teach؟ علم. Because you are making someone know. ما معنى درس؟
To
study. Or say, yeah. So ما معنى to teach؟ درس. That's why درس. To study. So a student would be, if دارس معناها to study, a student would be دارس. But دارس to teach, that's what we studied last session, how to give اسم الفاعل from more than three letters. Because when I say دارس, كم حرف؟
Four.
أربعة. دال را را دار and then سا. So اسم الفاعل is مدرس. علم اسم الفاعل معلم. More than four letters. More than three letters. جميل. So مدرس معلم. So نزل. The one who's come down, what do we call him?
نازل.
زل. But نزل. The one who sits down is the mean for فاعل is with a dhamma. معلم مدرس. So
نزل.
And here the زل is without a shadda. So أنزل اسم فاعل would be
منزل.
منزل. Because that's the زل without a shadda. So we put a ميم with a ضمة but the زل without a shadda. This زين was with a shadda. We put the ميم with a ضمة because it's more than three letters. We put the ميم with a ضمة when it's more than three letters. علم معلم نزل منزل.
That's منزل.
That's منزل.
That's.
Here, yeah.
That's منزل.
منزل. And من. زل. Yes. كسرة when there is a shadda it can go beneath it.
No, I know. Is that منزل as well?
منزل, yeah.
منزل, منزل.
منزل. we have ism al-fa'il and ism al-maf'ul. If it's more than three letters, the one who does the action takes a kasra. Munazzil. Munzil. But the one that the action is done to takes a fatha. Munazzal. Munzal. So, again, going back to darasa. So, a teacher is mudarris. A student would be what? مدرس. Okay. ما معنى درب with a dal?
Coach.
To train. أحسنت. To coach. So a coach or a trainer is مدرب. A trainee is مدرب. And if I want to tell you that this dog is trained, I say هذا كلب مدرب. هذا حصان مدرب. It's trained to do this. You know that the monkeys that they use in a circus or the lions. So we say qirdun mudarrab, asadun mudarrab. It means it's educated. It's taught how to do these things. Those who missed last session, you can copy the notes, because there is a system how to do that. It's not just a meme with a dhamma. We bring the mudari and you studied this. Yeah? That's what I'm explaining this, because you will see nazala on all the forms that I wrote right now. لذلك في القرآن الله سبحانه وتعالى وَنَزَّلْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. It's not mean, it doesn't mean that the rain is coming down. If the water is coming down, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending it down. نزلنا. وإن سورة الكهف الحمد لله الذي أنزل على عبده الكتاب. The one who sent down the book and was slave. الحمد لله الذي أنزل. أنا الله سبحانه وتعالى هو منزل. نزل التوراة والإنجيل. المنزل. جميل. ومنزل. The one who sends down in Surah Yusuf. سيدنا يوسف was saying to his brothers when they came to like it. He said to them, ألا ترون أني أوفي الكيل وأنا خير المنزلين. وأنا خير المنزلين. الله سبحانه وتعالى.
I'm the best one to send.
Yeah. الله سبحانه وتعالى says, أأنتم أنزلتموه من المزن أم نحن المنزلين. When Allah سبحانه وتعالى was talking about rain, so he said to the non-believers, have you sent it down from the sky, or أم نحن المنزلين, or we are the ones who sent it down. So منزلين. Okay, so now we know why we put نزل and أنزل as one verb, because it's actually one verb. نازل. Those letters are extra, and you can add them to any verb to transfer the meaning. طعم, to eat, to feed. أطعم. تاب. الفعل تاب. نحن اتفقنا. ما معنى اتفقنا؟
Agreed.
We agreed. نحن اتفقنا أن الألف ليست حرف. الألف ليست حرف. الألف مد. لكن ما هو الحرف؟ الحرف همزة. إذا كانت همزة إذا هذا هو حرف. إذا هذه الألف هي واو. Yeah. So الفعل تاب. It's actually تواب. تواب. And if it's a good Arabic dictionary, you will not find تاب. It doesn't exist. When you are searching, you have to search for a تاء followed by a واو. تاب الفعل تواب. تواب. لذلك عندي كلمة توبة مع التاء مربوطة. التاء مربوطة. توبة. And then I'm going to test a rule that we learned together when we were doing the verbs قَالَ. تاب. So a person who does tawbah, what do we call him?
Ta'ib.
What was the rule? I already have an alif here. And for fa'il, what letter do I add? Alif. Yeah? So I say kataba. So a writer is? Katib. So already to give fa'il, I add an alif. But the verb already has an alif. So originally it's like this. And in Arabic, if I have two alifs, it becomes alif med. Becomes alif med. So ta ib. And this is how you write it. You put the hamza on this. So again, so look at other verb. So qala. So ismul fa'il is qa'il. So that teaches you even how to write hamza. And you know why hamza came here? Because I had two alifs, so I made it alif med. تائب قائم. So كلمة تائب الله تعالى القرآن. Yeah. التائبون. التائبون العابدون الحامدون. All of this أسماء فاعل. تائبون عابدون حامدون شاكرون. All of this is فاعلون. واو النون للجمع. وهو فاعل تائب عابد حامد شاكر ساجد راكع. أني أدعو نون تائبون عابدون حامدون ساجدون.
The tayyib is the one who seeks repentance.
That one, yes. تائب.
So you know, for ya and wow, could it be both? Because for qala it's yakulu and qila.
No, that's different.
Because in Quran.
Qila. Yeah, I know. Qila. We'll come to this inshallah. She's saying sometimes you see a waw and sometimes you see a ya for the same verb. Like qala, the verb is yaqul and qawl. But sometimes you see it in Quran qila wa qila ya ardu bila'i ma. Why is that? This ya is not the original letter. What happened is that for a reason that we are going to study, the qaf had to have a kasra. You cannot move from a kasra to a dhamma. So what letter suits kasra from the weak letters?
Yeah.
So that's why it became qila. So the qaf didn't have a kasra because of that. It was the other way around. So this ya just came here for the convenience, but it's not originally part of it. Okay?
But
so,
the meaning is same, isn't it?
Qila ma'ana, it was said.
Someone said it.
Yeah.
It was said.
It's, we are going to study this, the active and the passive, the mabni lil ma'lum and mabni lil majhool. Yeah. So taba, ta'ib. And taba is fa'ala. What is fa'al from this? If taba is fa'ala. If tawaba is fa'ala. So fa'al is tawab. What is fa'al? We studied fa'al. Mubalagha. You remember when we want to exaggerate something, we make it fa'al. So that's why one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, At-tawwab. Wa ana at-tawwab ar-rahim. At-tawwab, remove the alif and la, that's the. And tawwab, put, that's the fa, that's the ayn. Alif as is because it's not part of the root. And la, and the shadda. So tawab is fa'al. Asma ilah al-husna. So taba, yatubu, tawba, ta'ib, ta'ibun, ta'ibat, tawab. Hundreds of times in Quran. In Surah Al-Ma'arij, sa'ala, sa'ala sa'ilun. So someone asked a question. Yeah. Sa'ala sa'ilun.
So maf'ul would be for taba. For tawa, maf'ul would be?
Matub.
Mataba.
Aw fa innahu yatubu ila Allah mataba.
Matub. Matub is?
Maf'ul. Yeah, you just add a name, and the fa'ala, and then the waw. بعد ذلك, عندنا الفعل تلا. أو تلا. ما معنى تلا؟
تلا
تلا المضارع يتلو. So the ألف is originally what?
To recite.
Oh wow. تلاوة. To recite. Yeah. That's a lot in Quran. يتلونه. أتلو ما أوحي إليك من ربي. تتلو وأنتم تتلون الكتاب أفلا تعقلون. أتأمرون الناس بالبر وتنسون أنفسكم وأنتم تتلون الكتاب.
What is تلا mean literally?
تلا معناها to recite something. أتلو ما أوحي إليك من كتاب ربي.
So it should be تلا should be تلاوة.
تلاوة yes. So it's originally تلاوة. If the end of the name of a person has حرف علة, ما معنى حرف علة؟
Weak letter.
A weak letter. You can remove this حرف علة and substitute with حركة. How is that? ما معنى قضى؟ قضى. To make a judgment. To decree. وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه. Okay. So the فاعل would be قضى يقضي سدس قاضي. قاضي. In Arabic you can say قاضٍ. So you can remove the ya and substitute with تنوين. Okay. تل أحسنت. So تلا يتلو. So I can say تالين. معنى هذا one brother.
So it could be قاضي أو قاضين.
Yes.
Either one.
Sorry, what
is
قاضي?
A judge.
A judge.
Someone who makes a judgment. A judge.
What would
we? With a shadda on a waw, because you are doubling it. We have the waw of tala, talawa, and you have the waw of maf'ool. So it's matlu. The verb is ta la wa. To get the fa'il and maf'ool, break it down. Talawa, like kataba, it's what? Fa'a. لا. Right? I need it to be مفعول. Quran itself, the thing that's being recited. Okay. So مفعول, what do I add? A meme he.
Yeah.
أنا واو he. Let's do the same. I add a meme he. أنا واو he. Two letters of the same type, what do we do? شدة. So مت لو, and instead of writing two up, does this make sense? Yeah. متلو, which is مفعول. في القرآن تلا يتلو ويتلى ما يتلى عليكم من البيت was being recited upon you. يتلونه أتلو رزقا رزقا. رزق معناها طبعا رزق موجودة في القرآن ويرزق من يشاء بغير حساب وهو رزقكم يرزقكم ترزقون ترزقون والرازق الرازق من أسماء الله ورازق على وزن سرزق الذي يرزق اسمه
رزق
رازق وفي المبالغة فعال is
رزاق
رزاق لذلك لا تسمي ولد الرازق لأن الرازق من أسماء لا تسميه عبد الرازق عبد الرازق أو عبد الرزاق. And this question might get asked. Someone would ask, why two names of Allah are the same, رازق and رزاق, they are not the same. رازق is مفاعل, رزاق الصيغة مبالغة.
And it means one who keeps
always giving. Always, yes.
Okay.
Always, yes.
So رازق could be anyone, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. رازق, yeah.
Any provider, but رزاق would be only...
Only Allah. Because yeah. someone may provide,
yeah.
but they will not be... Oh, can someone guarantee that they always can provide? No one.
Because when it says Allah khairul raziqin.
Ah, exactly. Because Razik can be anyone. Anyone, you can be Razik, you can be a provider, providing something for your family and he. That's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described him amongst Razik, he said, وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ رَازِقِينَ. He is the best of those who provide. But when he describes himself with sighat al-mubalagha, he does not say, وَهُوَ خَيْرٌ رَزَّاقِينَ, because there is no Razak but... But him. That's why when he describes himself to be Razak, we say, وَهُوَ الرَّزَّاق. Doesn't say khayr, because there aren't others to compare to. This is the difference. لذلك, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. Because people, you can call a person rahim, someone who has rahmah and gives the, like, you know, and like, you know, has mercy towards others, we can call them rahim. Yeah? But that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَهُوَ أَرْحَمُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. But can we call any person الرحمن or الرحيم? Cannot, because there is only one. Because here it's a form of exaggeration, we cannot. So I can call a person رازق, I can call a person سامع, I can call a person عالم. All of أسماء الفاعل, no problem. But I cannot call a person العليم, السميع. So this is a, so that's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of his characteristics is on the wazn fa'il, then comes before it something that sets him apart from the rest. خير الرازقين أرحم الراحمين. The word رب, you can use it to anyone. يعني الأب رب البيت, اللغة العربية. And even and if you're feeling a form and a wife is trying just to say she's a housewife, they say Rabbat Bayt or Rabbat Manzil. It means she doesn't want, she takes care of that. Like, you know, so because the word the Rabb ma'anaha Lord. Yeah, so Rabb, so mashhoor jidda, like very famous to say Rabb and Rabb. لذلك الله سبحانه وتعالى doesn't call himself Rabb. It has to be identified afterwards. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alam. He is the Lord of the worlds. He is the Lord of everything. Because a human being can be Lord, but Lord of your house, Lord of a city, Lord, but you cannot be the Lord of the Lord. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbun, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. So the word Rabb can be, but the word Allah can exist on its own. Why? Because there's only one God. We say, who Allah? You don't say Allah of what? No, Allah. So the things that can be attributed to others, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gets distinguished. And the things that are only for Allah, then they are mentioned on their own. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is غَفُور رَحِيم. You cannot call a person al-ghafoor, right? That's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to him as غَافِر, because that's a fa'il, غَفَرَ, so غَافِر, it's identified. غَافِرُ الذَّنْبِ. The one who forgives sins. Because people may forgive mistakes, but sins only forgiven by Allah. So He's identified as the only one who can forgive sins. غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد.
So similarly,
غافر
could be used for anybody.
رافع yet can be used for anybody.
Yeah.
To say رافع from رفع, so you can say رافع. But when you put ألف and لام, it's only used for Allah. Why? Because when you say that, it means the one and only.
What is
Rafa'a? Rafa'a to lift or raise. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala uses it like He's the one who raises those whom He wishes, and He is the one who puts down those whom He wishes. We say ruku'a, and then to stand up, في اللغة العربية, if you study the pillars of fiqh in Arabic, you say rafi' min al-ruku'a, rising from ruku'a. They say الرفع, so ركوع and الرفع. الرفع means like, you know, rising, like standing up. So رزق, رازق, لذلك كلمة رزق, the provision itself is رزق.
رزق. هذا رزق من الله. So that's a provision from Allah. رزق. فأما الإنسان إذا ما ابتلاه ربه فأكرمه ونعمه فيقول ربي أكرمن. وأما إذا ما ابتلاه فقدر عليه رزقه. And if Allah tests him by limiting his provision, فيقول ربي أهانن. He say, oh Allah, humiliated me. So رزق is the provision itself. So رزق, رازق, and مرزوق. مرزوق is the one who gets the provision. مرزوق. And sometimes, if you are lucky, like you know, some people, subhanAllah, they've got like a big share of this life. They start a business, it's very profitable. They do anything, they always like, you know, make a profit. And some others struggle to make even like, you know, 1/10 of what they do. So if in Arab culture, if someone is always, whatever they do something, they mashallah make money and there, we call them marzuq. And even they use it sometimes as a name.
Yes.
They call a person marzuq. So in a way, they put the name as part of a dua for them. Like, may you always have provision. So that's why they call them marzuq. And for girls, they name marzuqa. Marzuqa as well, for breasts. So marzuq is maf'ool. يقول يعني مثلا يقول هذا ولد مرزوق معناه whatever they like he does he gets like you know profit from it. مرزوق مثلا من أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم like هو مرزوق سيدنا عبد الرحمن بن عوف. يعني مثلا if you're describing him, كان صحابي مرزوق يعني like he always has رزق like whatever he does he. There is a difference though between marzuq and ghani. Because you may be marzuq but not rich, and vice versa. Because rizq is about that you always get money. But ghani, you can be ghani even without being marzuq, is that you inherit money, you get like, you know. But marzuq, it means that you are the one who bring this money. That's marzuq from rizq. You always have provision. Razaqa, yarzuq, raziq, marzuq, razaq. And رزق الاسم طبعا in القرآن I mentioned the اسم فعل اسم مفعول الاسم like رزق because the rest we already know like ترزقون يرزقون نحن نرزقكم you know like you will find the verb maybe in like at least in 12 forms because you've got أنا أرزق نحن نرزق أنت ترزق أنت ترزقين هو يرزق هي ترزق هم يرزقون يرزقون yeah. أنتم ترزقون always you مذكر واو النون هم يرزقون أن أنتم ترزقون. So القرآن نحن نرزقكم أنتم ترزقون من قل من يرزقكم من السماء والأرض. Who will provide for you from like السماء or the earth. So you'll find the verb in a lot of like you know different forms. Eh? نصر. نصر actually doesn't mean to help, literally. كلمة نصر معناها victory.
نصر من الله.
نصر من الله وفتح قريب. So نصر معناها to give support. There are difference between help and support. How is that? Because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in a hadith said, أنصر أخاك ظالما أو مظلوما. Support your brother whether he is on the right or the wrong. The Prophet said, O Prophet of Allah, عرفنا كيف ننصره مظلوما. We know how to support him if he is مظلوم. فكيف ننصره ظالما. How to support him if he is ظالم. He says, تكفه عن ظلمه. You stop him from this ظلم.
فذاك نصر. That's how you support, you help him. But so نصر ينصر, نصر ينصر معناها to support. نصر ينصر معناها to support or to give victory. نصر ينصر, يا إن تنصر الله ينصركم. So نصر ينصر معناها to give victory. لذلك كلمة نصر, نصر من الله وفتح قريب. Victory.
So to support, to give victory, to help,
yes.
To aid.
Yeah, to aid. نصر ينصر. So نصر الفاعل
ناصر.
ناصر الفاعل ناصر, والمفعول اسم المفعول
منصور.
منصور. لذلك both are names, ناصر and منصور. Both are names, famous names. ناصر ومنصور. جميل. So عندي ناصر وعندي منصور. So ناصر الذي ينصر, the one who gives, like the one who provides, the one, like you know who supports. And منصور, the one
who is supported.
Who is supported? Yeah, who is helped. And it can mean victorious as well. I said it before at the beginning. You use ism al-fa'il or ism al-maf'ul to make a dua. So when you say Mansura ya Quds, Mansura ya Gaza, Mansura ya Sham, it means like, you know, may you be victorious. Mansura. It's called the Mansura because this is the city that defeated the French colonization, and that's why they were kicked out of it. So they spread all over the country, and when they reached, like, you know, the area, that's where they got, like, you know, defeated, and they captured the head of the, like, you know, the invasion and things like this, and then they were kicked out of Egypt. So that's why it had the name of Mansura.
Mansura,
again, with a ta. With a ta marbuta.
Ah.
Because it's a city, Medina. So when you describe it, you have to put a ta, ta marbuta, Mansura. طبعاً in Quran, لقد نصركم الله إن تنصروا الله ينصركم. So you have the ta and the ya. يعني الفعل للمتكلم أو للمخاطب أو للغائب. First person, second person, third person. Sometimes Allah subhanahu says وَمَا لَهُم مِّن نَاصِرِينَ. They are not going to have anyone to support them. وَمَا أَقْصُ نَاصِر وَالْجَمْعُ نَاصِرُونَ أَوْ نَاصِرِينَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says وَمَا لَهُم مِّن نَاصِرِينَ, معناه they are not going to have anyone to give them support.
النصارى.
أحسنت. You know why النصارى, ما معنى نصارى؟
The helpers of Isa.
Yeah, the Christians. نصارى refers to Christians. Yeah, but because they are the helpers, they are the supporters of سيدنا عيسى, so that's why they were called نصارى. Put on top of that, the people of Medina, what did Quran name them? أنصار. أنصار. النصارى and أنصار the same meaning. Like support, all because they share the root. Nasara. So that even explained this. And in the story of Sayyidina Isa in Quran, قَالَ مَنْ أَنصَارِي إِلَى اللَّهِ قَالَ الْحَوَارِيُّونَ نَحْنُ أَنصَارُ اللَّهِ. Those who were named the Nasara, the supporters of Sayyidina Isa, and Al-Ansar, the people of Medina, because they were the support. They are the one, because the people of, look to see the difference between Nasara. Because I said it doesn't mean to help. It means like to make victorious, to support. Because that if the people of Medina were called the Ansar, weren't the people of Mecca helping the Prophet? They did. They offered everything that they had. But because when was the Prophet victorious? When he moved to
Medina.
Before that, like, you know, Muslims couldn't even pray in like public. So that's why they were called Al Ansar, the one who the supporters who brought victory. That's why the word Nasr has this hint of like victory with it. It's not just about a normal support. A normal support. Because you can get help, but you still get defeated. Right? So the difference between Nasr, it doesn't mean just help you, helped you till you become victorious. So this is the meaning of the verb. That's why Al-Ansar had the name Al-Ansar. Those who supported Sayyidina Isa were called Al-Nasara. Allah subhanahu says, وَمَا لَهُم مِّن نَاصِرِينَ. So أي شيء في القرآن فيه نون صار را,
It has something to do with assist or support that leads to victory. Not just help. إذا جاء نصر الله, it's not just when the aid of Allah comes. The aid of Allah was always there. The support of Allah was with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all the time since the revelation started. But Fathu Makkah, that was like, so the aid of Allah came and they brought victory, because all before this, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wasn't able to enter Mecca. The real victory when he returned to the city that he was sent at. So that's why إذا جاء نصر. But other than this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always supported. So
Nasara
is going to
year on year.
Nasara, that's just for jam'a. Like, you know, it's jam'u taksir. Yeah? So it's it. So Nasara. Yeah? That's not that. This is what I'm looking at. Nasara.
Okay.
Ansar wa Nasara. The same thing. They called them Masihiyin, because Sayyidina Isa, his name was Al-Masih. So they are Masihiyin. So one Christian, we call him Masihiy. Ya Al-Nasab, you remember? Ya Al-Shadda. We added to relate someone. So Masihiy, معنى the one who belongs to Al-Masih. So Masihiyin or Masihiyun. An-Nasara, so they are called the Nasara in Quran, because Sayyidina Isa, when he was sent, he said to them, Man Ansari ila Allah, who are going to support me? Qala al-Hawariyun, the disciples were learning, Nahnu Ansarullah. So that's why they're called An-Nasara.
Al-Hawar means people around him?
Yes. Yeah. You mean?
What would be the word for general help?
For general help, عانى يعين. عانى يعين معناها to help. That's why in Surah Al-Fatiha we say إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Look, the verb is عانى. Originally it's عيانى. Right? You remember, we studied together. When do we add a sin and ta before a verb? It means?
Future.
You, no? Sin and ta. Not a sin or to seek. ما معنى غفرة?
Forgiveness.
To forgive. To seek forgiveness is? So the sin and ta makes you seek what comes after. So, عينا معناها to help. To help. To seek help is? نستعين, because we, the noon, مثل نكتب, سين and تاء, to seek, and عين, we seek help. So general help is عانى يعين.
To seek help is?
استعانى. نعم. استعانى. And then you can write غفر, to forgive, to seek forgiveness is? Istaghfara. When you say, oh Allah forgive me, do you say Aghfirullah or you say Astaghfirullah? Look at Astaghfir. A is Ana. Seen and ta, seek. Ghafara is to forgive. I seek forgiveness from Allah. Okay? So
Istaghfara, isn't it? Yes.
Ma'am. So Ana to help in general. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'in. You can get help from Allah. We seek help from Allah. I mean, but Allah is going to offer you help. But does this mean you will be always victorious? No. لكن نصر. That's why in Quran, الفعل نصر comes in Quran with that form. فإذا استنصروكم فعليكم النصر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to the believers. He say, those who are allied to you, إذا استنصروكم. Look at this. So, استنصروكم. صاروكم. Look how big the word is. But then it comes down to ما الجذر هنا؟ نصارى. ما معنى نصارى؟ To make you to make victory, to support till victory. And then the seen and ta to seek. Okay. And then wow. مثل كا قالوا كتب جمع. So they
This waw is they. And kun is
you
o. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says إِذَا or فَإِذَا and if they seek your support like our support from you فَعَلَيْكُمْ النَّصْر. You have to make them victorious. عَلِمَ to know, you know, to inquire about something, to seek information is إِسْتَعْلَنَا and an information desk at an entrance of a hotel or a hospital, it was called isti'lamat information.
Say that again.
Yeah. Alima.
Yeah.
Ma'naha to know. If I put ista'lama, ma'naha to inquire, to seek to know. What's to inquire? To seek to know. So an information desk in the Arabic is isti'lamat. You see it in train stations in Egypt, in airports, in hospitals, in hotels.
Ista'lama means to seek help.
Yeah, to know.
To seek knowledge.
So to inquire.
To inquire.
To seek to know. If someone says, oh, I've got a lot to do and something, and we won't say, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help you, say, A'anaka Allah. May Allah, like, you know, help you. A'anaka Allah. نتوقف هنا إن شاء الله.
سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.